firemen. Nobody knows why firemen are firemen. Not even they could tell you why. But it is time somebody try. Firefighting is the most risky of jobs. Fire and ice are uncomfortable separately or together. Wives hate the hours, kids love the noise, fire and ice. Any day at the firehouse, the bell puts the dispatcher on the horn with a tenement tinderbox address into bunker pants, rubber turnout coat, grab the mask and go. Minutes later, you're on site. As others run out, you go in. You'll need all you can carry. The 4-pound axe, a 6-foot hook, the Halligan pry bar. The ceiling has to come down, and it's one of those stubborn tin ones. In the scary dark, you're gouging out and tearing loose and pulling apart, gulping air and tasting black. Your windpipe is closing, and you've lost track of which way is out. Is it really worth it? They've cut your ladder company from 6 men to 5, so now everything you do is 16.67% more difficult and more dangerous. Your air is low. Inside your mask, you're throwing up. There's a searing ember down your neck, torn gloves exposed, a smashed hand, so you emerge from the Holocaust hugging with your elbows somebody's singed kitten. Back at the station house, you can almost breathe again. Next come the tedious hours as you gang up on grimy tools. The cleanup crew at the firehouse is you. When windows need washing and toilets need cleaning and floors need mopping and beds need making, you do it. Is it worth it? Your B crew pumper swapped his day shift so some family guy could be home for his kid's birthday, and then outbound toward a false alarm, your buddy gets blindsided by a hot rod driven by a drunk, fire and ice. The intercom barks again. This time it's a warehouse, a big, fat, multiple blaze. On-site engine men draped with icicles, dragging a 3/4 pre-connect froze hose, are waiting for your big line. Laddermen can't make the building without you. Search, rescue, ventilate. Eventually it's over and out. Your smoke smudged and sleepless and wrung out. But this one you won. But the raging blaze that wanted to consume adjacent buildings did not, because you were there. Back at the firehouse before cleanup, you and the guys sit a spell, tired but they laughing, feeling good about one another. Nobody outside your world can ever know this feeling. In any other uniform, you get streets named after you. In this one, you risk your life to save people until one day you run out of chances, and at one final fire, either you buy it or you don't. And yet there is no third way that you'd ever leave this job, and you're doubting even God knows why. When you hear a familiar voice saying, it is worth it, and you're hearing this voice, and there's nobody there but you, it's a quiet voice from nowhere saying, it is worth it, fireman.
Smiling and happy, and joy was on your face. No longer searching, you were safe in love's embrace. Ooh. The night that you were born, the stars were bright. The deepness of darkness on a magic sky. I made a promise to stand always by your side. I see you being your own hero, standing tall with possibility. The long night is over now that you're safe in love. Ooh. Woke in the morning, opened both my eyes in the stillness, remembered a sudden vision cleared my mind of peace unspoken. Here's your miracle and mine. I see you being your own hero, standing tall with possibility. The long night is over. Now that you're safe in love, I see you being your own hero, standing tall with possibility.
Well, good evening, everyone. This is Ruth King. I'd like to welcome all the members of the Saranac Lake Fire Department and Saranac Lake Rescue Squad. I have a wish for you treasured people tonight. Now, I don't know if I get any more wishes. As you know, I've already been given my life miracle by you on that January morning in 1964 during the Hotel St. Regis fire. It was your very own former fire chief, Preston Burl, who saved my life, catching me from the five-story fall. This was an act of dedicated service and courage. My unspeakable gratitude for my hero will never end. And you guys are my heroes. You folks are my heroes, too. If I could ask for only one more wish, it would be this. I hope that every single one of you stays aware of how your dedicated service and your courage makes a life-changing, immeasurable difference in the lives of the stranded, the helpless, the sick, the hopeless. Your lives are legacies of love in this sometimes unkind world. I know. I was ostracized in a pre-civil rights USA just by the fact of my not being a Caucasian. In those days, it was a popular notion to see people of color as less than human, but not so with you. You heroes, trained and skilled and professionals, rush in and you stand as keepers and guards over the precious lives of those you save. You don't stop and ask a victim what their political views are or what nationality or what race they are. And you do this without career pay for it. This behavior can only be the result of your high regard for one another. When Peter Crowley of the Saranac Lake Daily Enterprise found me and was working hard to unite me with dear Preston Burl, I had about 24 hours to realize that I might actually get to thank my Superman. Because of the unfriendly welcome I usually received from the North Country neighbors back in the 1960s, a sad thought went through my head. I thought to myself, if he had known I was black, or colored, as they would say then, would he have still caught me? Oh, yes, he did. And oh, this kindness healed me in more ways than one. You are changing the world. You have changed me. I'm alive, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. And I'm only one of the countless that you've given your lives for. And I'm saying thank you, thank you, thank you.
Now that you're safe.